Well, it is one of the fastest growing legislative districts in Nebraska.
District 2 represents Cass County, parts of Sarpy and Odo counties as well. And six candidates are seeking the seat. One, an appointed incumbent. Another has a son serving in another district at the Capitol. One whose wife serves in Governor Heineman's cabinet.
KTV News Watch 7's Jeremy Maskell introduces the candidates in this Commitment 2012 report.
From the main streets of growing towns to the challenges facing rural farmers, Nebraska's second unicameral district has unique needs.
Agriculture needs to be represented, but also I'm part of the metropolitan area. We have to work together, and we do.
Ron Nolte says his years as a Cass County Commissioner and serving on the Regional Health and Human Services Board show he builds bridges between urban and rural groups. Nolte praises this example, improving Highway 75 into Cass County.
If we don't have infrastructure, we don't have anything in this state.
That's very important for our economic development in Cass County.
Robin Larson argues infrastructure is key to creating jobs in the district she hopes to represent.
We need to bring more businesses to our small towns, and we need to keep those businesses there.
Larson says years on the Weeping Water School Board and professional project management work would help her prioritize bills in Lincoln, where incumbent Paul Lambert has another priority.
Next session's going to be taxes.
Governor Heineman appointed Lambert to the District 2 seat last session. Besides Lambert's work to solve problems facing child welfare in the state, he says Nebraska needs to cut tax burdens without cutting vital services.
Maybe spread the load over more people and more industries and just make it more palatable for everyone here.
But Bill Kintner argues there's plenty to trim at the Capitol.
It starts with property taxes, the car tax, income tax. When you die, they're going to tax the inheritance for your kids to get it. If you got a company, it's corporate taxes.
Touting tax cuts is his top priority, protecting schools, roads, and public safety, but changing things like Medicaid.
We made Medicaid closer to private insurance and just had a slight copay. It would fund some of it and discourage its use.
Mel Luchins also wants to work statewide protecting schools, saying voters are worried about education's future.
I think by finding some new ways and some new formulas, hopefully, for support of schools.
He hopes to use experience working with interfaith organizations.
We're going to have government. We're going to live together. And so my idea is let's make it work.
Speaking to government's reach on his 7 acres near Greenwood, Robert Howard says his top priority would be limiting the use of eminent domain, whether it's for projects like a pipeline out west or something else in his district.
I would prefer to change it so the state, city, and county cannot own the property. If they have to, they can lease it for the period of time they will need it.
Six different perspectives from diverse candidates, just like the district they're running to represent. Jeremy Maskell, KETV, News Watch 7.